Hey, Melanie Beckler here. In this video, I'm excited to share with you my top 7 crystals for protection. A common question I've gotten recently is what are the best crystals for protection? And whether that is for protection from electromagnetic frequencies, from detrimental energies in the external, from entities, from negative thought patterns, or from negative energy, or even psychic attack energy from others, crystals are a really helpful and powerful ally for this. And so I've compiled some crystals here to share with you that are my top picks for protection for a little bit different reasons depending on the stone, because they each do have their strengths. And so you can then determine which of these you really seem to resonate with, because that's also a key thing in choosing the right crystals for you, is where is your resonance? Which ones are you really drawn to? Which ones feel good to you? That's a good indication of that crystalline energy being beneficial. Also, while you don't need to program crystals, I do usually program my specific crystals for protection with clear intention. If you're interested in learning my process for programming crystals, comment below with a quick yes or no about whether you'd like to see a how to program crystals video for protection. Okay, so let's dive into the crystals I have to share with you today, my top 7 picks for protection crystals. The first is, of course, black tourmaline. By the way, these are not in any particular order other than kind of the order I jotted some notes down. So black tourmaline is one of the most well-known crystals for protection, and it really is such a beneficial protector overall. It protects your physical body, it's incredibly detoxifying, and it does protect against electromagnetic frequencies, as well as general negativity and thought patterns and detrimental energies. One of the limitations I've found with black tourmaline is that it works very localized. So you really need to have your black tourmaline on you, close to you, in your purse, in your pocket, or wearing it as jewelry for its protection to really be working. It also isn't really bulletproof, I would say. And so specifically targeted negative intentions towards you from others in the form of psychic attack or curses may not be totally protected by black tourmaline. However, black tourmaline is still super valuable, and I like to have lots of it around for its protective grounding properties. And the second stone I have with me today for protection is black obsidian. I have this black obsidian sphere that is so powerful. When crystals are cut into a sphere like this, it amplifies their energy in a way that it sends energy out from all directions. Normally, black obsidian is a little bit different because this is one of the most absorbent crystals there is. Now, technically, obsidian is not a crystal. It is volcanic glass, but its structure is so similar to quartz that it's pretty much universally considered to be a crystal. And since it is volcanic glass, it carries the alchemical fire energy and also is incredibly absorbing. So to me, black obsidian really carries the energy of a black hole. So it pulls everything to it, and it is incredibly protective. So it's going to absorb all sorts of detrimental energies, negativity, psychic attack, negative entities even, that come into proximity. But one of the things that I really, really love about black obsidian that's so powerful and kind of rare when it comes to crystals is that it's so highly programmable. You can actually program it to protect you, leave it at home, you then go to work, and it's still working to protect you against psychic attack and negative energetic influence. If you're new to programming crystals, you probably want to refresh that programming weekly at least. Again, comment below. I'm planning on sharing my how to program crystals, but let me know if you would like to learn the specifics of that. But essentially, the obsidian can act like a decoy. So negative intentions, ill wishes, hexes, curses sent towards you, consciously or unconsciously by others, the obsidian can absorb. Now, it doesn't neutralize it, and it doesn't transmute it. It doesn't release it. It holds it. And so at some point, it will become less effective unless you go in and consciously clear the energy of your obsidian. I have a video on how to cleanse your crystals with light. I will share that. But also, obsidian especially responds well to soaking in salt. So just in a tray of salt, setting your obsidian in that with the clear intention and flowing your light energy to cleanse it, to release whatever it's absorbed back into the light. So black obsidian, that black hole energy, is so powerful and such a powerful ally. Super grateful to have that. One more thing I do want to share about obsidian is that obsidian used to overwhelm me a little bit because of that strong pulling energy. It also has the tendency to bring up within you unintegrated shadow aspects of your consciousness. So if obsidian feels a little bit heavy for you, you might want to check out snowflake obsidian, which has the same protective properties but is a little gentler, or gold sheen obsidian, which this actually has a gold sheen. You probably can't see it, but when it's in the sunlight, is connected to the great central sun, the source of light. So it has light within the darkness, and I really like that. So obsidian, black snowflake or gold sheen, as well as the pure black obsidian. Next up is indigo gabbro. I've talked about this stone on another video. It's really currently one of my top favorite all-time crystals, and one I'm recommending a ton recently because one of its most unique properties is that it is adaptogenic, meaning that it will bring you the energy you most need in the moment. It's also incredibly centering. It is highly programmable as well. And in addition to its incredibly protective properties, protective against all sorts of detrimental energies, entities, electromagnetic frequencies, thought patterns, it works across the board for all of that, but it does also, with its violet and indigo energy, have the ability to transmute much of that, so you wouldn't need to cleanse it as much as obsidian. Really ever, I still recommend cleansing all of your crystals, but indigo gabbro will transmute much of the negativity it absorbs while also being centering, protective, and spiritually uplifting. So again, in my opinion, this is one of the best stones for protection against electromagnetic frequencies, as well as really all sorts of detrimental energy. So I wrote an entire blog post about indigo gabbro. I will put a link to that in the description below, along with a great place where you can purchase it, because it can be a little bit harder to find. It's a relatively new find in the world of crystals, so not all crystal shops carry it yet. Next up is shungite. I have this shungite pyramid. Shungite is an incredibly protective stone, especially for detrimental electromagnetic frequencies, which we're all constantly bombarded with and which really is increasing. And the pyramid shape does also amplify further the energy of the shungite. In addition to its ability to absorb electromagnetic frequencies, it's able to take on all sorts of detrimental energies that may have become contained in your aura or in your space. I like to keep shungite near my computer when I'm working. It's a great stone to have by your Wi-Fi router. I actually have shungite and indigo gabbro by my router together. And in addition to the protective properties, it is also very stabilizing and detoxifying. So that is an extra benefit of using shungite for protection. Next up is amethyst. Amethyst is an incredible stone. It is incredibly spiritually uplifting and also protective on a spiritual level, on the spiritual planes. So amethyst, one of the unique things about its protection is, as you can see from the color, it has this beautiful purple violet energy. So it's very connected to the energy of the violet flame. It is able to transmute much of the negativity it takes on. And so having amethyst in your home, it's constantly working to create a spiritual energy that is safe and that you're supported and protected in. So amethyst transmutes a lot of negativity, but it also then absorbs negativity. It's a little more general all around, so I wouldn't say it's as bulletproof as, say, a black obsidian sphere, as taking on entities and curses and hexes, but it is beautifully and powerfully protective in a spiritual sense, and it's also so uplifting and just beautiful. So I love amethyst. Next up is lapis lazuli. Lapis is so protective on a psychic level. This is honestly one of my go-to forms for any time I'm under any sort of psychic attack, or if you feel like you're a target for black magic, lapis lazuli is a great ally. It's also protective on the mental level. So it protects against detrimental thought patterns, which could be sent your way from entities or from people you know. Lapis is great for maintaining clear thinking. It was well known to be a royalty stone, and so maybe that's how the kings and queens of ancient past would use the lapis lazuli as well. But it is beautiful and powerful. It of course has so many other beneficial properties. It's psychically opening, but this video is focused on protection. So for the psychic level of protection, lapis is a great choice. Finally, the seventh crystal for protection I want to share with you today is smoky quartz. Smoky quartz is a stone of power and protection. It's very protective against electromagnetic frequencies and general detrimental energies. It is very powerful, and it can actually absorb a lot before you need to consciously go in and cleanse its energy, so that can be a perk. It does also have a pretty wide radius for the area it can cover. I don't feel it's quite as wide as like obsidian or fluorite, which could be used remotely, but smoky quartz does have a wide range in how it's able to protect you. So it would be a great stone to grid your home in, or to just have a magical piece like this in the home for protection. One thing I do want to point out about smoky quartz is there are some varieties of it that are almost black. This does happen naturally within the earth. However, it's pretty rare. And so most of the black smoky quartz you see on the market has been artificially irradiated, meaning exposed to radiation in order to cook it, in order to get it to be that dark black color. I don't really like that. I don't feel its energy is as pure, as benevolent, as beneficial after it's undergone that harsh treatment. So I really recommend, with all crystals, trying to find them in their most natural form. For smoky quartz, that is usually this lighter color. However, again, there are some sources of the really deep black smoky quartz, which is generally even more protective than this color would be, but you have to be really careful and sure you're buying from a reputable dealer who knows the source and knows whether that crystal has been treated. Smoky quartz is also a great protector against psychic attack. And while it's not self-transmuting, it can pull in and ground a lot of scattered energy around. So at the level of thought patterns, it does effectively handle a lot of that energy, grounding it to the earth. And so that's part of the reason why it doesn't need to be cleansed too often, though I of course do still recommend cleansing your crystals. Finally, the last thing I want to share about smoky quartz is that in addition to being protective on an emotional, physical, mental, spiritual level, it is really spiritually supportive too. It can help you to establish a link with the higher dimensions, and it is great for meditation. So those are my top 7 crystals for protection. I hope that this has been helpful for you. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. Comment below again if you would like to learn the process for programming these crystals of protection to make them work in an even more focused and efficient way. I can share that with you soon. And really, if you'd like to learn more about crystals, comment below and let me know. I love hearing from you. I want to create content and helpful guidance that you will appreciate and enjoy. So let's talk in the comments below. As always, I love, honor, and appreciate you. Thank you so much for watching. Give the video a thumbs up, subscribe here on YouTube if you have not already, and then I will see you in the next video. Bye for now.